My name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Tuesday, September 22nd, 2009. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the things we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Now, before I get started, I'd like to request your feedback on this video. Whether you're watching this video on FX Bootcamp's YouTube page or our Facebook page, or maybe from a link on FX Bootcamp's Twitter page or even on our blog, please leave a comment when you're done watching this video. Even if you just say hi or thanks, that would be very much appreciated. Now I'd like to clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer Bootcamp members are trading on a demo account, so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. What you now see is a pair of charts showing the Euro-USD currency pair as it looked at 8 a.m. New York time, again, 8 a.m. New York time, on GFT's Dealbook 360 trading platform using FX Bootcamp's custom layout. On the left is a 15-minute chart, and on the right is an hourly chart with daily pivot points and Fibonacci extensions of yesterday's range. Now, 2 hours prior to this point in time, in fact, very close to the minute that I started my London lunch session today, the Euro reached a point just 3 pips shy. You can see it in the top of this chart here, just 3 pips shy of my daily R3 pivot point, which I'm displaying as a horizontal green line at the top of this chart. Now, it's not every day that a currency pair reaches its R3 pivot point, especially before the start of the New York session. That's also not every day that the dollar makes a 1 year low, at least against the euro, which at today's high, it has come very, very close to doing. This is a Euro-USD daily chart you're now seeing. And on the upper left-hand side of this chart, you can see the last time, I'm circling right now, the last time this pair closed above the 1.48 level happened to be exactly 1 year ago today. So we essentially have what you can call a double top on this daily chart, a one-year double top there. Now, by the way, those of you who track the DX, again, the DX, may also note that it's nearing one-year lows as well. Now, back here on the 15-minute chart, I see that the euro has also reached the weekly R1 pivot point, which is yet another source of resistance, representing that weekly R1 with a horizontal maroon color line. And I also note that the euro has put in what you might call a full day's work. Again, a full day's work. The thin horizontal gray color dashed line in this chart, that represents the level at which the euro had achieved the 20-day moving average of its daily ranges. By the way, that's data that I post on the FX Bootcamp blog each weekend. So those are the technical reasons why this currency pair might be essentially done for the day. Now, I've also got some fundamental reasons as well. This is the second day in a row without major U.S. news on the news calendar, but that's not the case over the next 3 days. We've got FOMC tomorrow. That's the interest rate decision from the U.S. Central Bank, the Federal Reserve. Housing news the 2 days after that, and we end the week with a so-called G20 meeting. Now, what that means is the currency market, and for that matter, several other financial markets, might stall out today as they wait for the outcomes of those news reports and events over the next 3 days to come. In fact, stalled is basically what we already have seen thus far today from most of the yen crosses. Check out this 15-minute chart for the pound-yen, which is, by the way, the pound-yen has been one of the more volatile currency pairs over the past couple of years. Not only do we have what we like to call an inside day, I'm defining the high and low for the day, and note that it falls within the span or range of yesterday's high and low. Actually, so you can redraw this as a trap, something like that. So not only do we have what we like to call an inside day on the pound yen, but also this pair has managed to move just half of its normal daily range from high to low here, about 90 pips on this pound yen. Now contrast that with the euro, which has not only moved more pips than the pound yen thus far today, but also exceeded its average daily range over the past 20 days. So that doesn't get me very excited about trading the yen crosses. Now those are the reasons why I said something to the effect that it could be a slow New York session today, and I said that more than 1 hour before the New York session started. Now that may not be what many of you eager traders in trading want to hear. Again, traders in training, I should say, want to hear. But I remind you that if you're going to survive in the long haul as a trader, it's at least as important to know when not to trade as it is when to trade. Moving forward on this 15-minute chart, the Bollinger Bands tell the story here. Those two gray lines represent a sort of gauge for volatility, and when they're both flat and parallel to each other, as they are on this chart now, it means there is no significant volatility. In simple terms, the market really isn't doing anything. The red vertical line on this chart, on the right-hand side of this chart, represents today's London close. Now, I should add that we did talk about a long trade around in here. That's a bounce at the 15-minute 21 EMA during the 30 minutes after today's New York Open. We even talked for those of you who are USD bulls or looking for a countertrend trade. We talked about this move down from a lower high compared to the high for the day, close to the daily R3. Actually, both of those trades, the long from the 21 and the short from the weekly R1, both of those trades produce profit. Were enough pips for profit. So regardless of your bias, up or down, it was possible to make some pips. But it's safe to say that the euro's best hours today were in the Asian and London sessions. If you chose not to trade, then congratulations. On some sessions, no trade is the best position to take. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Tuesday, September 22nd.